I would like to share the pempek sagu from Palembang to my kolezanka and kolega in Poland. I hope they can give me answer whether my pierogi from Palembang is the same with pierogi in Poland. So let me see how they respond for it. Okay. So how is your? Yeah, eat first. Carol, what's my go? So how is my pierogi from Palembang? This is my hometown actually, but it's not from Turk, from Flam. What do you think? Is this same like pierogi in
Poland? Is this your first time?
Yes. To be honest, yes. No, 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 it's serious. No, this one is a pierogi from hometown, actually from Reba, but this one is only from
Flam.
Yeah.
So how is the tomato? How about you?
Very good.
Really?
Yes, it is. I like pierogi and I like pumpkins and everything.
But this one is inside is
inside. Inside is only vegetables. I think. Yeah, very good.
Delicious.
Then eat more.
Very good.
But is this same like pierogi?
And it looks beautiful. Yes. Like Polish.
Yeah. Well, Polish. Yeah. Is it similar pierogi. Like pierogi? Similar or not?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Very similar.
It's the same.
Polish
pierogi.
Okay. So, but inside the if pierogi is original in Poland, what is the inside the pierogi?
Meat.
Meat.
Meat. Yeah. Or mushrooms.
Mushrooms.
Col and mushrooms.
Ah, mushroom. Okay.
And col.
Oh, col. What col? Kapusta.
Kapusta.
Ah, kapusta. Ah, similar. For us, actually, yaiko. Yaiko.
Not different the mushrooms.
Not
mushrooms,
just
the brown
color, the
one, right?
Mm-hmm.
So
next time I
love you,
kiss me, okay?
In Poland we have a lot of types of mushrooms, so we are using different types of different meals.
Then it's honest, comment inside, yeah? Okay.
I should repeat what I said.
Okay.
So yeah, different types of soups, different mushrooms to pierogi, and different for, I don't know, salads or
salad is different,
pizza or something like this.
Okay.
Yeah.
So next time if I make from fish, would you like to try not? Pierogi from fish? You never tried before?
Yes.
And then we use the zupa.
I won't because I hate fish.
you won or you like?
I don't like
you
fish.
You don't like fish? Oh, okay. Okay, this one. Oh, you don't.
Very good.
Okay.
Thanks, guys, girls.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, so thank you, ya.
Yes. Okay, jen dobre. Jumpa lagi dengan saya Linda di video saya Linda Sie. Okay, tadi seperti kalian lihat ya di video saya awalnya, I already sharing. Pempek sagu from Palembang to my colleague Zanka and colleague in Poland. So, in their opinion that pempek sagu Palembang is a similar like pierogi in Poland. So, I'm so happy that they like it and then the taste is similar, ya. So, bagi teman-teman yang ada di Indonesia, terutama yang bagian Palembang ya, itu teman kantor saya bilang kalau pieroginya itu pierogi di sini ya, karena di sini pierogi is one of traditional food in Poland. It's very famous, especially when Christmas time, they will serve pierogi especially ya. And then, mereka bilang kalau pierogi itu mirip dengan pempek sagu loh. Nah, cuma nanti saya akan coba ke depannya, saya akan coba buat pempek Palembang dari ikan. Jadi saya bilang kepada teman kantor saya, next time I will try to make pierogi from reba or fish. Okay, so now let's see how to make pempek sagu from Palembang. This time I make the filling for the pempek sagu ya, pempek sagu Palembang. So a bit different. Yeah, because I still have the kapusta. Okay, so the ingredients is like this. I use the kapusta or cabbage and also the mushroom. This one is I already mix off ya. After with the water, rendam di air. I also add the prawns. And then this one is the garlic and also the onion, the red azelona. Chosnak, the bawang merah ya. Bawang merah dan bawang putih di blender. So this one is blender of garlic and also the yellow red onion. And then this one is the onion. And for the seasoning flavor, I use this one, the salt, pepper, sugar, and also the seasoning. So seasoning is not necessary, but this one is just to make tasty, yeah. So this one is ingredients to make the filling for the pente sagu. Okay, so after this one, the Teflon pot, so as we fried, yeah, fried the garlic first. Ini kita masukkan garlic ya sama bawangnya. Kita apinya api kecil saja. And then add in the onion. So kita aduk ya. So we stir this one. Okay, the smell is very very nice. Then we mix this one, the mushroom, menjamur kuping ya nih ya, and stir again. Then we add the cabbage, ini masukkan kubis ya, ke dalam ini. Wow, penuh, very cool. Then after that we just add the prawn ya. The prawn actually you can cook first before the kapusta, okay, based on maybe after, but for me I do after ya. And then after that we stir again. And then kita masukin ini ya, semua seasoning, the flavor, the salt, kaldu ya, atau dan juga nih garam. A bit stick now in the salt. Yes. Teman-teman, ini sangat wangi loh. It's a very very nice smell. So you should try this. Ya. Yeah. And then make sure we just stir, yeah. It's not necessary must stir all the time, you can cover. And also make sure later this one is a bit brown and soft. So this one after finish and the color changed to a bit brown, yeah. Setelah warnanya agak sedikit kecoklatan ya. Terus kita angkat. This one, teman-teman ya, later I will use for filling for the pempek sagu Palembang. Bener-bener harum loh. Now I'm preparing the main point to make the pempek sagu Palembang. Jadi sekarang akan saya membuat ini ya, bahan utama untuk membuat pempek sagu Palembang. So the first is the flour. The flour about 0.5 kilo, and then after that, this one is a 2 pieces or 1 pieces of egg, but we can use the white and yellow egg together. And then this one is a tapioca about a half or half kilo or maybe the 3/4 from the flour. And then this one is the water, so about 0.4 to 0.5 liter. And then this one is a 1 tablespoon of the oil. Later this one use for the boil ya, boil the flour. And after that for the seasoning, the flavor, we use the salt. And also for the seasoning, this one saya pakai kaldu ya, kaldu. So this one is the ingredients to make the pempek sagu Palembang. So the first kita masukkan air ya, so we add the water. Then we add the oil ya, ini apa minyak untuk masak. We add the oil to make something not too sticky ya for the flour later. So I just add about 1 tablespoon of the oil. And then we mix with the flour. We need to stir ya, stir and stir the flour into the water and also the minyak ya. Jadi kita aduk-aduk ini sampai nanti mengental ya, until the a bit sticky. Another method to make this one is sometimes they use the boil the water first, after they just add on the flour, but this time is I boil the water and then add together with the this one the flour. So this one is to make the texture is more soft. Kondisinya something like this ya. So we just add the seasoning, the salt and also the seasoning ya, the kaldunya. Nah, after that we stir back. Jadi teman-teman, ini setelah saya campur apa tadi ya, seasoning and the salt, and then make sure the condition of the flour is like this ya. Not too hard, also not too soft, not too watery I mean. Okay. So after that we just keep it cooling ya. Kita simpen dulu agak sedikit sejuk atau dingin, nanti baru kita masukkan the egg. Okay. So after cold then we just add the egg. Okay. So here is the flour after we keep cooling ya. So after this one cooling, setelah dingin ya, after that we add the egg. The two pieces of egg. We just mix it together. And then teman-teman, I already wash and clean my hands ya. Yeah. So same as like we make a tight one. So we just use the hand to stir it, yeah, to mix it together. So why we use hand again? Just to make the textures better. So we just mix like this. Ya, yeah, pakai telur ya. Kita campurkan, tapi make sure ini, make sure this one is a cold ya. Yeah. Otherwise it's very hot. Not easy to mix. Okay. Kita we just add the egg. Actually this one is to make the texture. The texture is good and also to make the taste. The taste will be nice, yeah. Then after we mix the egg, then we add, now we mix the tapioca. So one by one, yeah. So we just add one by one and then mix it again. Try two spoon first. After that we mix, use hand again. Okay, teman-teman, make sure the texture is like this after we mix together with the tapioca, ya. Yeah? So after that, we just make a pattern and filling the just now the kapusta or cabbage and with this flour. Okay, teman-teman, again I already wash my hand and clean my hand. Okay, so now I would like to make a pattern or make the tempe sago. So to make the texture good, ya. Yeah, so we also can add our hands with the oil. Yeah, and then after that we also can use the tapioca to make the this one, yeah, our hand is more soft, yeah, when tossed to the dough. Okay, so let's we try and start. Okay, just to make like this, yeah, small like this, something like this, a bit bigger. Like to make pattern. So make sure bentuknya macam ini ya. The pattern is like this. After that, we filling the kapusta just now. This is the kapusta or cabbage, so we just put inside. After that, we cover. Tutup ya. Inilah pierogi from Palembang. So but no, in Indonesia, my hometown, we call pempek sagu. So the pattern is like this. So you also can make the flower, yeah, so like this, yeah. After that we just fold like this, peel, we just fold make like this, yeah. So, inilah teman-teman. Ya, bentuknya macam ini, like a fan. Okay, maybe not too beautiful, but it's like this, yeah. So, this one is how to make tempe sagu. So, we also do the same for the second one, yeah. So, just peel like this. Then, make a ball like this. After that, we filling with the cabbage. Isi lagi ya teman-teman dengan cabbage yang kedua. Ini cabbage-nya also add the prawn and also the mushroom, so very special. Actually Palembang is a can use the egg. Usually they use egg ya, but or maybe the one papaya. Papaya. So the filling is up to us. What do you want? So this is my tempe sagu. Similar like kapusta, no? So is it similar like pierogi? Pierogi also like this or not? I don't know how to make pierogi. Maybe someday my Polish friend don't mind to teach me how to make the pierogi. So this one now I try to prepare pempek sagu or pierogi from Palembang, my hometown. So this one is the second one. Beautiful or not? So if you want to make a pattern just like this, yeah, pull here. And then fold, pull here, pull ya, and then after that fold, then pull here and fold like this, and then pull, fold, pull and fold. So we make a pattern. Yeah. So this one is second one. Nice or not? Cantik nggak teman-teman? Kalau cantik nanti komen ya. Okay, the taste is must be yummy. Okay, teman-teman, aku baru saja selesai ya buat pempek patternnya. So I just finished make a pempek sagu Palembang the pattern. So I make a two type. One is like this, another one is like this, ya. So a bit different. So after this, we will boil into the boil water. Same as we make a third one. So we must boil the water first. After that, we just put the pempek into the boil water. So like this, yeah. So just push one by one. Also the same. So if we to make sure the pempek is already boiled, yeah, make sure the pempek later will come up to the on the top, yeah. Sampai apa dia timbul ke atas ya, baru itu masak. Kalau sekarang kan, and as you see ya, the when we put below, they will down, ya. Yeah. So that means this haven't fully cooked, I mean. So make sure like this ya. If tempe already cook well, so they will come up ya. Yeah. Same like we cook that one before. But we just leave it for a few minutes to make sure inside cook very well, yeah. So after like this, so we just lift up. So inilah pempekku. So to be careful ya, one by one here. So inilah pempekku. Mana pempekmu? Pempek sagu Palembang. Oke, teman-teman, inilah pempek sagu Palembang dengan filling kapusta atau kubis ya, kubis, shrimp and also mushroom. So, inilah pempek sagu Palembang.